Welcome to Whitley Strieber's podcast studio. I'm here with him today to have a retrospective discussion on his book, Jesus, A New Vision. Whitley, can you explain to us about this new vision?
Yeah, I've been very interested in the Jesus story for most of my life. And my wife, Anne, was very interested in it and knew a great deal about it. And I had realized some years ago that the canonical gospels were chosen for maybe the wrong reason. They were chosen in order to give a church a reason for being, but there was something different. Jesus' teaching isn't actually like that. And I decided that I would write out a book that I'm not a religious person. I'm not part of any, I don't have any axe to grind. I don't have anything to put over or anything like that. So what I did was this. I took a new look at Jesus. I had to relearn my Greek, which I knew from college, in order to read things like the early gospels in the original language as best I could, and some Aramaic, and even some hieroglyphs, if you can believe it, so that I could have this in my own mind and not read translations that were actually created by people who were believers. And it was quite revelatory. There is a gospel, probably the earliest gospel, called the Sayings Gospel of Thomas. This is a group of sayings of Jesus. Now, in the canonical gospels, Jesus is God, and everything is holy writ. What he says goes. But Jesus appears in a very different light in the Sayings Gospel of Thomas. At one point, Jesus takes one of the disciples aside and tells him a secret. And the others want to know, what is the secret? What did he say? And he says, if I told you that, you would have to stone him to death. And then at another point, Jesus says, don't follow the dietary laws. If you go out into the world, go into any house and eat whatever they have to give you. Jesus says also, don't believe me. Don't accept me as a teacher. Find yourself and your own teacher in yourself. And these are things that the churches don't want us to believe. He was saying in this very early gospel, you take your own journey, you be your own teacher. And this is the inception of Jesus, A New Vision. It also goes into the Shroud of Turin, which has been dismissed as a fake. It's no fake. It was never meant to be a fake. My wife and I helped finance the original studies on the Shroud of Turin. And when I heard that they were planning to send some of the material to Oxford to be dated, I wrote one of the priests involved and said, don't do this. They will not date it correctly. I'm not saying that they're going to lie, but it will go wrong. And that's because these people, they can't afford for their paradigm to collapse. And if the shroud was from the period of Jesus's life, then you have to conclude that it is something truly extraordinary. They took a piece of the shroud that was also had carbon on it from a fire that had happened in the 16th century. And the result was the dating takes it back to the early medieval era. The truth is very different. It is original from that period. And for one of many reasons is the type of weave in the shroud was not being done in the Middle Ages and hadn't been done for hundreds of years. So that's all in the book. And then there's also an explanation of why Christianity came about. What happened to the Roman Empire was this. The sun in 100 AD changed the amount of energy that it was sending out. And the result was the Mediterranean basin, and in fact, most of the planet, dried up. And we know this because of stalactites that have been studied in Scotland. And the Roman Empire at that time was enjoying something that's known in science as the Roman climate optimum. And that ended very suddenly. And suddenly there were these millions of people in this empire with a very primitive distribution system and very simple and primitive methods of farming. And they started to have massive famines. And with those famines came plagues. And it was so terrible, they lost faith in their gods. And they began to abandon the temple and destroy the statues in the temples. And a brilliant statesman and politician, Constantine, came along and realized that in those days, there was no such thing as this is the state and this is the church. It was all one thing. That he had to reinvent the gods in order that the people would continue to believe in the state. And he chose Jesus to be the new God. And that's how it began. That's how Christianity began. Before that, Jesus was a teacher. After that, he became a God. Jesus, a new vision, is about returning to the teacher.
So one thing that really struck me as you were talking about the sun and how it changed its intensity.
Yes.
Now, currently, right now, we're having the sun, the geomagnetic, the electromagnetic flares that are coming from the sun. Can you explain that a little bit?
Well, we are in a solar max right now. They happen every 11 years, and this one is not unusual.
Okay, this is normal.
Hopefully. I mean, there was one in the 1850s that sent out a X-class solar flare that's been rated at X75. This solar max is not unusual so far. Back in 1853, there was something called the Carrington event, which was a solar flare that was rated at in the solar flare rating system at X45. Most solar flares that get to that level are like X1. X2 is extremely unusual. If we had another X45, it would be hard for us. But so far, so good. This solar max has been pretty normal.
Okay, that's great. Thank you so much. Thank you for joining us and listening to Whitley's description of his process. And we hope that you join us again.
In this book, we can talk about this. I did read this one.
Oh, you did? Okay. Yeah. Okay. So it's